Yo, what is going on, everybody? My name is Connor. You guys, of course, can call me Doom Superior. And welcome back to the channel for another video. Today, I actually got a super dope video talking about something in Call of Duty World War II that is ridiculously overpowered, as well as a shit ton of fun to do, use, and try out in Call of Duty World War II. So we're going to talk about that. We're going to get down and dirty. But first, I want to do the giveaway. It is the 2 weeks of Christmas here on the Slow Superior channel, and every single day I am giving away $20 of COD points in every single video. Okay, now we're gonna pick the video or the winner from last week's video, and that winner is Ninja Shots or Jack Vallis on Twitter. Congratulations, man. You won the $20 PSN gift card. I will be contacting you via Twitter. If you want to enter the giveaway on this video, all you have to do is subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications, which is the little bell button right next to the subscribe button, hit the thumbs up button on this video, and then comment down below with what your Twitter is so I can give your prize if you are a winner. So once again, just subscribe, turn on notifications, hit the like button, and comment your Twitter down below to enter to win a $20 COD point card. But what is going on, everybody? Thanks a ton for tuning into this video. Today, we're going to be breaking down one of the newest weapons in Call of Duty World War II, one of the most underrated weapons in Call of Duty World War II, and I'm going to highlight a playstyle that can really benefit you guys. If you do it well, you do it properly, you take your time, you play smart, and you listen to the tips that I'm going to outline in this video, I guarantee you guys can pull off some pretty crazy gameplay. So, we're going to be talking about the Gewehr 43 rifle in this video, alright? And I want all of you guys to tweet me your best gameplay with the Gewehr. However many kills it is, tweet me a pic of the scoreboard, or just tweet me a pic, just telling me what is the most kills you got with the Gewehr. Personally, I touched 60 the other day using this gun in hardcore domination. The Gewehr is a single shot rifle that they just added to the game, and as you guys know, single shot weapons are freaking overpowered in hardcore. The reason being is single shot weapons do way more damage than like a full auto weapon because it's a single shot. You have to pull the trigger each time you want the gun to shoot a bullet. You can't just hold it down. So each bullet in turn delivers a higher damage. And in a game type like hardcore domination or anything hardcore where the enemy's health are so low, you literally one shot people if you hit them in the foot. It is crazy. Using a single shot rifle like the Gewehr in hardcore is the equivalent of using a sniper rifle in core. It is a one shot kill, and you have a decent fire rate with very low recoil, okay? The Gewehr has a higher fire rate than any of the other semi-auto rifles in Call of Duty World War II, and that high fire rate is what you need in hardcore paired with a really nice damage. So the Gewehr is just a fucking beast in hardcore. You see in this gameplay, I just go ham, just one-shot kids. I'm able to get so many double kills. You can get two kills with one bullet with the Gewehr if you collateral headshot them, and to see the power like that in a game mode like hardcore is just fucking insane. It's so overpowered, and it's a beast class setup. Now, something that makes this class setup better for me than I think it would for like a viewer watching this video is I have a Battle Beaver controller. And if you guys remember the video I made on the Battle Beaver, I talked about one of the features that they added on it called Smart Triggers. And what Smart Triggers does is it basically removes the entire dead zone on your trigger. So the only, like, instead of pulling the trigger, you press the trigger. It's just a little tap, it's a little button instead of like the long range of motion that you traditionally go through on like an Xbox One controller or a PlayStation 4, even an Xbox 360. And what the smart trigger does is it just makes it to pull the trigger, it's just like one little push. There's way less range of motion, and you can shoot way more shots way faster and like send way more shots and just pull the trigger and tap the trigger trigger way faster to literally make the Gewehr an automatic weapon. I'm going to play you guys a clip of the Gewehr shooting as fast as I can with the smart trigger, and then I'm going to play a clip of another fully auto assault rifle shooting, and I want you guys to listen and see how close the fire rates actually are. The Gewehr, when shooting at fully automatic with the smart triggers, literally shoots as fast as some of the full auto guns in Call of Duty World War II. And that is absolutely insane considering the damage profile on this thing. Now, there is a downside. The Gewehr only has 10 bullets in its clip, because obviously if they made a gun that shot this fast, did this ridiculous amount of damage, and had a big clip, it would be way too overpowered. So it does only have a 10 bullet clip, but if you put on extended mags, you can get 15 bullets, which I would say is definitely worth it, and I would recommend doing that and putting that on your class, especially in hardcore. You can spray a lot, you can wall bang, and really connect with a lot of lucky kills, which makes this class setup just all in all way too overpowered. The Gewehr is a one-shot, one-kill beast in hardcore, and if you're using a controller like a Battle Beaver with the smart triggers, or even if you have a product like Trigger Devils to kind of emulate the smart triggers that the Battle Beaver controllers has, it is really overpowered, and it can turn the gun from something that is like just feels single-shot and doesn't feel like it's a viable weapon at close range. It can kind of change it and can really transform the experience that you feel with the gun, and I can definitely attest to that and say that is true. All right, so the Gewehr, I think it cost me about 8,000 armory credits to unlock, and I unlocked the epic version through the quartermaster. I wasn't lucky enough to get one out of a supply drop, but for 8,000 armory credits, I definitely think it's worth it. I was lucky enough to get a couple of the pieces I needed for the Gewehr collection out of like winter supply drops, but sadly I still had to spend 8k, but it was definitely worth it because the gun's fucking so overpowered that I felt the need to come and make a video on it. Also, if you do want a Battle Beaver controller, I'll link them down in the description. You can use code SUPERIOR for a huge discount. All right, you literally get like a 10% discount. I don't think it's 10, but I know it's greater than 5. It's like an 8% discount if you use code SUPERIOR. That is a bigger discount than any code on Scuf Gaming website. So if you want a really inexpensive, or not really, but if you want an inexpensive, reliable controller that's going to improve your gameplay, Battle Beaver is just no doubt the freaking way to go. With the smart triggers, the buttons, and the durability, it's the way to go. So you can use code SUPERIOR. Let me know what you guys think. Do you think the Gewehr is pay to win? A lot of people on Twitter were even saying that they thought the Gewehr was bad. I guess I could maybe agree with that if you're not playing hardcore, but personally, if you're playing in hardcore, it's a totally different game. It is just 180 altered, because with that lowered health, it completely changes what guns are good and what guns are bad. Like guns with a high fire rate or high damage are instantly way better than they might have been in core because of the low health. So that is why I think the Gewehr, when you kind of bring it into hardcore, it's totally different. It totally changes. The high fire rate on this gun is insane. I don't think the only gun that has a similar fire rate that is semi-auto is the M1 Carbine. The M1 Carbine in Call of Duty World War II has a decent fire rate, but honestly, compared to the recoil and damage on the Gewehr just blows it out of the water. And I think that kind of makes sense because it is a supply drop weapon. It's something that they want you to kind of feel like you need so they can get your money, and that's not a new tactic we've seen from Call of Duty at any point in the past. Honestly, Call of Duty is notorious for pay to win weapons, ladies and gentlemen. I think we are all perfectly adjusted to that. But I do hope you guys did enjoy this video. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I'm giving away $20 of COD points every single day until Christmas Day, so we got 12 more cards to be given away. Oh no, 13 actually. So make sure you comment your Twitter down below, because that is how I am going to contact the winner. Make sure you're subscribed with notifications on so you don't miss a video. Also, if there's any content you guys want to see on the channel covering any guns or supply drop videos or reaction videos or anything like that, let me know, because I am on the video grind, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know what you guys want to see, and I will make that for you, and I will bring it to the channel, because that's what I'm about, man. I want to make what you guys want to see. So let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much, every single one of you, for watching all the way to the end of this video. I love you guys. Let me know your thoughts on the Gewehr. Because I love it, dude. It's an overpowered one-shot kill weapon. Honestly, it's a great gun. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a fantastic day, everybody. I'll catch you all later. Peace out.